Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Okay, so on this channel today, I'm going to be giving you 5 different buttercreams every baker should try at least once, yeah? And you know, buttercream is awesome. We love it. But before that, please make sure to give me a thumbs up on this video, please. And subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, because I make awesome content. Okay, so number one, like you know now, American buttercream. It is so easy, and beginners, like, it is perfect for beginners because you don't need any technical know-how. All you need is some icing sugar and some butter and maybe some milk and maybe a little bit of salt in no particular order, basically. So it's really easy. So I'm going to be giving you the pros and cons based on my own view. I think American buttercream is easy and it's fast and it colors perfectly and it has amazing texture. For me, those are the pros. But for the cons, I think it's too gritty and it's way too sweet, like annoyingly sweet for me. Okay, so number two, we're going to be considering Swiss meringue buttercream. This is my personal favorite, and I think if you have a business, this should be your go-to buttercream. Okay, so for this one, you're going to be needing some egg whites and some white sugar and some flavor, and then basically you need to make a meringue. It's a meringue based buttercream and it is not as easy to make, so you need some help. Basically, if you've never made it before, you need maybe to watch a video or get a recipe and know the step by step on how to do it. And for me, one of the pros of Swiss meringue buttercream is the fact that for me, I think it's healthier, especially if you have customers. You don't want to just feed them butter and sugar. So it's a lot healthier for me. And then it is lighter and it is glossy. It has this beautiful glossy, I don't know. And it is so smooth. It gives you this amazing smoothness on your cake. And it is very fluffy and very easy to work with, basically. But my problem is it doesn't really color well, yeah? And it takes a while to make. Like, it's not something you can just whip up in a second. Okay, so number three, we're going to be considering the ermine buttercream. Ermine, I don't know how it's pronounced. Sorry guys, forgive me. Okay, so for this buttercream, you're going to be needing some flour. Like, some people refer to it as cooked buttercream or boiled buttercream, or I don't know, but you're going to be needing some flour, and you need to cook the flour first, because like, you can't just use raw flour, do you get? So you're going to be needing some flour and butter and like some sugar and everything. It's not a buttercream that is very fast or easy to make. This is not very popular. Most people don't use it a lot. But my favorite part for this buttercream when I tried it was the fact, I think I'm going to make a recipe and post on YouTube for you guys, was the fact that it tastes just like cream cheese. I'm serious guys, it tastes almost like cream cheese, but it doesn't have any cheese in it. It's just cooked flour and sugar and butter and stuff, and it pipes so well, and like, it is very rich. It has this rich, you know, taste and everything. And it has an amazing texture. But what I don't like about it is the fact that you have to always refrigerate it, because it spoils really fast, and you can't really put under fondant if it spoils fast, because you know, I'm sure you get me. And it is not too sweet, so like, you can basically use it for, you can use it for most cakes, because you can't use it under fondant. Okay, so number four, we're going to be talking about the German buttercream frosting. The German buttercream frosting is almost like the ermine buttercream, but this one has a custard base. So instead of using just flour, you're going to be using like a custard base, and it is awesome. It tastes amazing, guys. It tastes wonderful. And I think for me, the basic pro is that it tastes wonderful. Like, it is delicious. Especially if you want to make a red velvet cake or like a decadent chocolate cake, it is perfect. But the con is that I think it is too yellow. I didn't really like the color it gave me. And it is, you know, when you have a yellow base, it's difficult to color other colors like blue or purple, you get. So I didn't really like it. Okay, so finally, we're talking about the Italian meringue buttercream. A lot of cake decorators use this, and like, they've raved about it, how it's awesome and everything. And for me, it's not very different from Swiss meringue buttercream, except in the ratio of ingredients you use. Basically, you're using the same ingredients, egg white, sugar, like pasteurized egg whites and everything. So for me, it's not that different. I haven't actually tried this buttercream, to be honest, yeah? So, but I read that, yeah? I read and I watched videos, and like, I learned that it is easy, it is sweet. It's almost like Swiss meringue buttercream. It's just like, it tastes more decadent. And the difference is that you need to be putting very cold butter when you're making it, instead of just regular room temperature butter in Swiss meringue buttercream. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video and you loved it, because I enjoyed making it for you. And if you want to see more of me, just follow me on Instagram as _kickmeaway, and subscribe to this YouTube channel, Kick Me Away. And I have more than 130 free YouTube videos for you guys here. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.